听到两位主厨要来的时候，我是非常高兴的，而且 Chef Volonis 跟李主厨、都是业界的一个非常大的前辈跟好的厨师，所以我觉得我想要带他体验台湾后花园花东的这个整的食材的生态。
这次就跟着尹娜还有美英嘛，然后一路这样走上来，看到整个的山的感觉非常漂亮。
It's very impressive. I know there is a huge diversity of everything in Taiwan, but I'm very impressed today.
这边的阿美族，他们平常呢去外面去野外，他们就随处就可能散步一下，回来就会有一大包的野菜。他们的吃法会比较是会凉拌，就是盐稍微腌一腌，然后加辣椒，他们喜欢吃辣椒，加酱油，对，就这样吃。
那哪边最好吃？头还是尾？
一样。
这些野菜会让你想到说，哎，在创作的时候该怎么样去运用，然后就会真的产生很多的兴趣。
So many herbs, so many plants that we taste today.Was some, most of them bitter, but some we find some acidity, bitterness, sweetness. I'm very impressed by the variety of things that it's edible here.
厨师其实就是要蛮常去做产地的旅游，从产地去思考菜肴跟变化。这也是我一直待在花东所体验到的一个灵感跟创作的来源。
那我们成功渔港这边是花莲台东最大的渔港，像花莲跟台东他们比较经济价值比较高的渔货还是会用车子再过来我们这边做公开拍卖。我们这边的渔船作业的方式大概都是以当天现有的为主，就是说早上就半夜的时候他就出海了啊，在我们十二点拍卖以前他就回来了啊，所以鱼货都是很新鲜。我们的旗鱼跟鬼头刀是属于顶级的，像鬼头刀的话哈，因为它肉质饱满，啊，因为新鲜嘛哈，啊，它又没有什么刺。一般我们做鱼排啦、干煎啊，或是下去油炸，都是很好吃的。像生鱼片的话哈，白肉旗鱼哈，它的肉质相当 Q 弹，相当好吃，油脂高的话，吃起来那个口感非常好。啊，所以是做生鱼片最好的食材，因为我们这边哦，因为地形啊，因为气候的关系啦，所以我们这边的位置是得天独厚的啊，因为又接近太平洋，它的渔业资源很丰富，所以像鬼头刀跟旗鱼嘛，它是属于那种洄游性的鱼类啊，它每年它这样子洄游的话，都会经过我们这个渔场啊，所以当地的渔民就有这个条件，所以就造就了我们成功镇。这个渔港的特色，
It's
free, you just want them to do your show.
Wow.
Yeah.
现在的麦麦其实是比较肥一点的，尤其在这个季节，它的风味上也会比较好。啊，因为麦麦这个只要做到生食的，它的 Q 弹的那个口感会比较多，这样。嗯，
是。我喜欢这个。
Nice.
Yeah. 喜欢。And with the acidity of the lamb, it will be one. I like sashimi, but I like to see so what texture, what cooking can bring.
好吃，很香。
Flavor, yeah.
Yeah.
你好，
你好，爷爷好，
欢迎你们来这边看看那个阿公来炒海盐。
好，
你们要想知道海盐的一个工作吗？
好啊，
可以让你试试看看去炒一下。那我先表演给你后，也很快的工作，要不然你就眼睛会很痛。你是把它嘟，然后你再嘟。
一般我们的盐巴大部分是日晒，那这个是用木头漂流木材烧。把一个海水煮干，然后就干掉了，就变成盐巴。你要浓缩的水，你要最少你要10个小时以上啊。如果你要做金字塔的话，可能15个小时到20个小时。
这样可以做出多少盐？
如果说你一天的话，可能就有2斤半而已。
15个小时，2斤半。
对。
I try my best.
If I can add a coop, huh?
现在也差不多已经慢慢慢的干了。
阿雷阿雷。
因为这个腌化的艺术方式，另外的步骤，同样的一些煮的时候，把那个浓缩的一些海水，然后做成的，可是那个做法煮法就不一样，就是慢慢的。大中小，慢慢的一个小火这样。很多的人来这边都很欣赏嘛，啊，他们说，哎，又鼓励我，他说这个东西已经在失传了嘛，没有人在做，那你为什么会做这样？因为我都回答说，我就很喜乐，很开心。
So okay. Today we're gonna present like the mai mai. So we brine or roll it. Okay. Then after we're gonna wrap it with those leaf, that's aborigine leaf. So this one, there is the fattiness and little bit same taste than the spinach. Okay. Just simple seasoning. We're gonna use the olive oil.
Olive oil.
We're gonna use just pepper because yeah. After it's gonna
without
be
the salt.
Yeah. Okay.We continue all around the fish. As you see, just think that the sea salt, the salt okay. crust, like you
oh,
just
so
made,
fast.
Really oh. nice. And then we're gonna use dot to bake the fish.
Bake the fish.
Yeah, with okay. those Madeira wine leaf.
Wow.
So with the other leaf that we find this morning from the forest, we decide to do a different recipe again.
Okay.
With those nightshade leaves, that those specific one like taste little bit like almond. We do a pesto, and then with this pesto we do a stuffing, like the stuffing that
okay.
you can find
what, here. Okay. What's inside the stuffing?
There is ricotta, peanuts, parmesan.
Ricotta, all kind of parmesan. Oh, okay.
And then not too much, and you do the same on the other side.Justin, today you're gonna cook something like you told me on the phone last time that is a bit French but with Taiwanese twist, and then you want to present all those Aborigine herbs and the fish inside that plate. So please explain me a bit more.
I'm going to make a bouillabaisse. You know bouillabaisse?
Yes.
In the Provence,
yes.
You know?
Yes, yes.
So I'm going to use mahi-mahi to yes. make a bouillabaisse with a little different. Yeah, with ama sauce, okay?
Ata sauce.
Yeah, ama right. sauce.
But so what kind of preparation is this one? What it tastes like?
Yeah, this is a bouillabaisse, you know.
This one is the bouillabaisse.
Traditional bouillabaisse
soup. Yes.
Yeah, the taste is the same.
It's the same.
Just I make bowl, then after I do, you know, boil it. It's oh, wow. hot inside, but inside it's leaky.
And, yeah.
Yeah. So
that's interesting.
Just yeah. To make another dish for the salad, can you pick for me?
Which one you want to explain?
I need all, you know, just
so
mix.
Just some mix?
Yeah, only the leaves. Yeah.
Let me
the tender in. Part, you know, only tender part.
Okay.
So, ask
me for those small pieces.
Lemongrass for the flavor. Mm.
I think you really done a great job, you know?
Thank you.
Very well balanced. I think you pay attention for every detail.
Mm.
Even the every flavor.
Yeah, very, very nice. The ravioli is amazing with the fish. It's new flavor for me. 这跟我之前吃到的 bouillabaisse 完全不一样，因为其实我之前在法国马赛 Bertinis 做，所以我们那里也有一道非常知名的 bouillabaisse， 这是完全颠覆一个全新的 bouillabaisse 的一个新形态的呈现。它的 flavor 啊，它的整个一个风味啊，就是很当地很 local 的一个台东的一个风味的一个 bouillabaisse。
But it's really well made. I love it.Very well done, yeah. I would love to try it now together with the...
Ah,
I think yeah. it's a, yeah.
For me, I think the biggest interesting part is with the two chefs going to each store. Actually, different scenery and people and things also bring the two to explore the whole interesting part of Hua Dong, whether it's in the sea or the coastline.因为我觉得这时候是深入了解当地的一个食材，对我来说都是跟两位一起是一个全新的体验，跟我自己又不一样的感觉。
我虽然用过很多的这个 mahi mahi， 但是其实我没看过这么多，一次看到这么多的鱼，然后这么多的种类，我是觉得整个鱼市场让我感觉到了很强劲的生命力，所以我觉得这个地方让我留下的印象是真的非常的深刻，而且是非常好的印象。
When we go to the mountain and go through all those edible flowers, Aborigine herbs and everything, it seems that everything is edible.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, we can pick mostly everything and that everything is edible. So that was the most crazy part for me during that long that journey.
这两天跟两位很开心，欢迎随时再回来花东。